Welcome to FAB. Well, if you can't catch more fish than Shane after this show, take up marbles. Coming up, real estate, that's anybody's dream. Shane makes the great escape and more jet skis at full throttle. Sometimes even the best laid plans can go astray. Shane travelled over to the York in search of the elusive salmon.
It's a great day, we've got the beach to ourselves, as you can see. There's some really nice deep gutters on this beach, and I'm sure they're going to have some salmon in them. I'm not going to stand here talking any longer, we're going fishing. When you're fishing for salmon using pilchards as bait, it's probably a good idea to use either two or three hooks. It holds a full pilchard pretty well. And dentists recommend that you don't bite nylon fishing line. Sliding on the second hook here, perhaps tie them three or four centimetres apart. And I'm using about 40 pound trace line here. It may seem fairly heavy, but it does get abraded by the sand and whatever else out there, so the last thing you want to do is have a salmon break your trace. Well, this is the way I like to bait a pilchard for surf fishing. I like to put the first hook in just behind the gills, push it all the way in, and make sure that the point and barb are well exposed. Now, that's not going to put the fish off, but what it is going to do is to help to hook it and it takes the bait. But the second hook goes in a couple of centimetres back, push that all the way through. And this is the important part. I like to make a half hitch in the trace and put it securely around the pilchard's tail. That helps to hold the bait in the cast so it won't come off.
Well, it ended up being one of those days that all fishermen have from time to time. No matter how hard we tried, those salmon just wouldn't play the game.
We've been here for about 3 hours now without so much as a bite. And as you can see, the enthusiasm from the crew is starting to dwindle a bit. The fishing's a patient game. We'll hang on for another hour or so. We could get one yet. We'll keep trying.
Well, as it turned out, we didn't. But we'll be back later in the show with some hot snook action from Kangaroo Island. The name platypus has been synonymous with Australian fishing now for 100 years. Now, back in 1898, it wasn't nylon, it was either gut or cord. But today, the company makes some of the very best fishing lines in the world. Starting off with the pre-test, which is great for game and sport fishing. The pink, which is a general purpose, hard-wearing, knock-around type line. The platinum, which has terrific knot strength, it's very thin. And best of all, I like this new Super 100. It's called 100 to commemorate their centenary in business. It's very thin, very, very high quality stuff. If you really want to get value for your fishing line dollar, you can come in here to the sport fishing scene and actually buy it by the meter.
The line machine can take reels of any type. It saves heaps of time re-spooling. And it also winds the line under the correct tension. Bulk line's definitely the way to go if you're after value for your fishing dollar.
Tonight, a marvellous two-hour special with legendary adventurer Ben Cropp. We'll visit places few people have ever seen, exploring Cape York Peninsula and Australia's wild north on John Liddell's World Around Us. Tonight, 6:30 on 7.
This is a demonstration to show how new lawn tamer from Yates slows the growth of your lawn. You'll only have to mow it half as often, and the lawn will become thicker and lusher. Watch. We might need some help here. Thank you, ladies. See? New lawn tamer from Yates. A beautiful lawn you mow half as often.
Summer is coming, and the quickest and easiest way to get all the things done in your house is at Bunnings. You can get everything you need at the one place and all at the lowest prices.
Osram insect repelling gloves, just $1.50 each. Big 10-kilo bag of heat beads, alone $9.93. Black and Decker saw a bargain at $75. 4-litre Dulux timber colour acrylic, only $36.95. And this 15-litre stack in their storage crate, great value at $5.
Bunnings! Lowest prices are just the beginning.
The guitar, the songs, and the voice of Creedence Clearwater Revival belong to John Fogerty. Now, John Fogerty's solo brings his classic hits to Australia. Relive the magic when Triple M presents John Fogerty Live. On stage at the Entertainment Centre. Tickets on sale now.
Belonging to RAA Insurance means you save in so many ways. We save you worry when you need to make a claim. We save you time, because we're here for South Australians as the state's number one car insurer. And you can be absolutely sure that we have the best protection for your car. Little wonder, most South Australians trust and belong to RAA Comprehensive Car Insurance. There for you, always.
Sunday, big game fishing in the tropical north. Then below the surface,
diving on the magnificent Great Barrier Reef.
Steve catches a rare fish on Red Hunt's North Queensland Fishing Adventure. 5:30 Sunday on 7.
Grab those checkbooks, because we'll be looking at real estate from the marina soon. But first, here's Andrew from the Department of Fisheries.
As recreational fishers, you should be aware that there are bag and size limits that apply in South Australia. We have with us here today Dave McGlennon from Sardi Aquatic Sciences to tell us about a little bit about where the numbers come from. So Dave, what role does Sardi play in determining bag and size limits?
Sardi is the government research agency responsible for conducting biological research into South Australia's fish and shellfish species. And that biological research forms the basis of our recommendations on management of those species.
Okay, well let's take size limits. Where does a size limit come from?
A size limit comes from an understanding of the biology of the species and usually has one of two different purposes. The first one is to allow an individual fish at least one chance to spawn in its life before it's subject to fishing pressure.
Okay.
The second reason that size limits come into play is to increase the amount of meat that we get off our fish. For example, with these garfish, we have a smaller one 23 centimetres and a larger one 26. Now right. That's only, it's less than 10% difference in length, but there's more than a 30% increase in weight off those fish. So by adjusting the size limit, we can get the maximum value for the fish we catch.
Right. Some species have an upper size limit. Where does that come from?
Again, we're looking at maximising the amount of eggs that are spawned each year. And as fish get larger, they produce more and more eggs, from 30,000 in a legal size snapper up to more than 600,000 in a 70 centimetre snapper.
What about bag limits?
Bag limits are a couple of reasons again. One is to put an upper limit on the total catch to try and control the catch. The other reason is to share it a bit more equally around the recreational sector itself.
So as recreational fishers, we can make a difference. Know your size and bag limits and stick to them so that we can fish for the future.
Now, one could be forgiven in thinking that we're at a waterfront estate in the middle of Queensland somewhere. In fact, I'm in South Australia, standing here with Andrew Chapman at the marina Hindmarsh Island. Now, and tell me a bit about the marina.
Well, Laura, you're right. It's very much the Queensland-orientated waterfront living right here in South Australia within an hour of Adelaide. It's really quite accessible. Whether you're approaching retirement or whether you're still active and work on the South Coast, it's a great place to live and have access to this great recreational facility.
Oh,
if you're sailing or a fisherman, it's great to have the boat. Mm. Be able to get out there and enjoy. A month's cruising right up to Echuca and beyond.
So it looks like I might have to start saving my pennies to become a permanent resident of the marina Hindmarsh Island, right opposite the Murray Mouth.
It's a busy little place out here at the Adelaide Fresh Produce Markets. Judy Bickmore, all sorts of things happening out here.
Oh, it is. It's always full of excitement out here.
Indeed. Let's get on with our cooking today with Manny's Fresh Seafood out there at the Norwood Parade. Sam Clemente, what have you got for us?
Good afternoon, Steve. We've got South Australia fresh oysters. Absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
We have our chopped up bacon
mm-hmm.
and mum's chilli sauce.
Ooh, okay, and mum's chilli sauce. So you're not going to tell me the recipe again for that, are you? That's a Manny's secret, is it?
Actually, mum won't even tell me.
Oh, there you go. Not passed down from mother to son, then?
No.
All right,
no.
So what we're going to do is put the...
Well, I've already done three, so it's taken a bit of time, Steve, but very simple, easy to do at home as well.
These are deviled oysters, by the way, as we forgot to mention.
They are deviled oysters. Just add your bacon onto your oysters.
Yep.
Top.
And a bit of the old chilli sauce on top. And
that's
it.
Sauce.
Simple as that.
That's it. And you bake it in the oven for about 2 to 3 minutes.
I just need a little bit of heat on the top. So that's easy to do at home in the oven or wherever else.
Heat just the top, Steve.
Mm.
Not need down the bottom.
Well, you slip down there. I'll talk to Judy about our capsicum and mushroom bruschetta.
Mm, beautiful. Great entree idea. You want to take over the stirring?
Indeed. I love stirring.
Okay.
Away you go.
Well, we've got some onion and some garlic, some oil in there, just browning. We'll add some of the red capsicum.
Yours.
And the Merbein mushrooms. Now, the company Merbein Mushrooms started at Merbein in Victoria, but they're actually growing them here in South Australia as well, down at Morphvale.
Good.
So they're all locally grown.
That's good to hear.
And these are just the white button mushrooms that I've chopped. We'll pop
very,
that in
very
and give
fine
it a
onely
stir.
Too, I'm glad.
Oh.
Next, a bit of parsley.
Parsley.
Yep. Followed by some...
basil.
Basil. I love the basil. Basil just adds that little bit of flavour, doesn't
lovely.
It? All right, there we go.
Add a little bit of black pepper.
Yes, mandatory.
Now what I've already done is I've got some, just some French stick, some wholemeal French stick, and I've already grilled it on one side.
Okay.
We're actually going to put this mixture on the other side of the bread.
Okay, not on the toasted side.
Not on the toasted side, on the other side. Okay, I'll do one just to show you.
Okay.
Okay, so then we'll just put these in the oven for about 10 minutes in a hot oven set at 200 degrees.
And a bit of cheese on top.
Bit of Parmesan cheese on top.
All right, Sam, you're ready to go here. Let's have a look at those. There are the deviled oysters from Manny's with the bacon, the chilli sauce, and magically,
ta-da.
Judy, you've just produced it there. That's the capsicum and mushroom bruschetta.
Beautiful.
As we said, great entree idea for Manny's and the Adelaide Fresh Produce Market. See you next Saturday, guys.
No matter what water sport or activity you're into, safety must be held as a high priority. And that's why we've got the life jackets. Now, Rob, tell us a bit about the life jackets we've got here.
Laura, this is what used to be known as a life jacket. It is now known as a PFD, personal flotation device. This is a style which most people have, and they have it thrown in the bottom of their boat. The one I'm wearing is also known as PFD1, most of the buoyancy on the front, and a collar to support the head in the water. But Laura, this is a PFD Type 2, which doesn't have the collar, has buoyancy front and back, and is generally worn by the sailing fraternity. The style you're wearing is a PFD 3, which is worn by the water skiing wakeboarding fraternity, and both the 2, 3, and the type I'm wearing, the Type 1, is legal as far as use on any type of boating in South Australia.
Okay, Rob, tell us about children's vests and vests for teddies.
Yes, Laura. First of all, don't put your child in the type of jacket. This one is just too big and really might not save the child.
Mm-hmm.
You are far better buying a jacket which is the right weight and also the right size for your child.
Thanks, Rob. So there we have it. Make sure you have the right PFD for the right sport.
After the break, four-wheel driving on the beach. But first, here's the latest from the 7 News desk.
Coming up in the news at 6, a baby boy lucky to be alive after being bitten by a snake. Thousands of motorists breath tested in the latest blitz. A new treatment for breast cancer, and we go behind the scenes on next week's Christmas pageant. Nobody knows news like 7.
600 lounges, sofas, dining suites, kitchen suites, done from $99. 400 beds, ensembles, dresses and war units, done from $99. 300 fridges, freezers, washers and dryers, done from $99. $500,000 in repossessed, stolen, retrieved, liquidated, custom seized, second hand and show home furniture, done from $99. 300 gas lift chairs, desks, pedestals and partitions, done from $20. Where? Mr. Bankrupt's new mega warehouse, 69 Bordeaux, Devon, next to Rockers. Open 9 till 6 Monday, Friday and all weekend. And open late on Thursdays.
Buying a brand new car is an exciting time. And not just because it entitles you to a generous discount off your motor insurance with SGIC.
Here's an unbelievable offer from Proud Australia Holidays. This summer, cruise the Mighty Murray aboard the elegant Proud Mary for only $295 for a two-night cruise and $695 for a five-night cruise. Save up to $600 per person. Everything is included. All meals, stateroom accommodation and daily shore excursions. Go cruising with Proud Australia Holidays for almost half the normal price. Phone 8231 9472 now to make your reservation.
Right here I've got Tomo Jackson from Gympie in Queensland. Now, Tomo, I believe you've developed an interesting angle on the established tradition of polo.
Yeah, well, for a start,
we don't stuff around with horses.
Yep, I'd like to see those pussy polo guys, an old killer here.
Oh, he's away! All right, ride him! Do it for your country! Oh, great work there, Tomo!
Yeah, well, the games aren't too long, but I'm not sure that bothers me, really.
Well, you really are an original. You deserve the original Thirst Crusher.
Solo, the original Aussie Thirst Crusher.
Sometimes you may need to take your four-wheel drive on the beach just to find that special fishing spot. Greg from TJM taught the FAB girls some valuable lessons.
Now, if you're taking your fishing off-road, chances are you're going to run into some sandy patches, much like this down at the Murray Mouth. Now, we've got outboard explorers, and we've got Greg here from TJM Products to give us a few tips and help us out on what we should and shouldn't do.
Thanks, Laura. There's three important aspects that we should look after in terms of four-wheel driving, particularly on sand like this. The first one is to keep your tyre pressures low, and that will give you a balloon flotation effect with your vehicle floating over the top of the sand rather than bogging in. The second one is to keep your wheels, your front wheels, aimed straight ahead, and you do this by holding the steering wheel in a 10-2 position. And we'll see that inside the vehicle in just a second. The third one is try and stay high side wherever possible so that if you do strike some soft sand and get bogged, you can aim downhill and that will aid your momentum so that you're not fighting gravity. Righto, the first thing we're going to do now is decrease the tyre pressure. So we've just dropped the tyre pressure to 20 pound and that should be enough to get through this particular situation. And if we need to, we can always go lower. Well done, support vehicle. You're supposed to be here to help us.
Yeah, it's all right. We'll get there.
We can get out of this. What we need to do is build a flat pad of sand so that you can then get enough momentum to get over this pile of sand which is pushed up in front of your wheels. So what we're now going to do is do a reverse forward technique to make that a solid pad so that you've got the momentum and the traction that you need to get moving. So we're gradually building up a bigger distance in which to get that pad of sand going, and we're away.
Well, it looks like the weather's going to do it to us again. We're back here in American River on Kangaroo Island. 3 weeks ago, we had a big southwesterly to contend with. Today, it's a big northeasterly. We just can't win. But I'm with Ian King. He's the local expert. If we're going to get any fish, it'll be with him. OK, mate, where you go? Oh, we've been trolling for quite a while. On the coast down here, Port Morrison, and I've got a snook at last. Had a hit just a second ago and I missed it, but this one's hooked up all right. Don't know how big he is, but we'll find out in a second. Had two or three chops of that then before he hooked up. Not a monster, but he'd be a keeper. That's a keeper-sized snake. One of these Minnow lures. It's a Hawkeye lure. It's called a fighting whiting, this lure, would you believe? And dives to about 3 metres, and that's about the right depth. So, at last, success. If you hang in there long enough, you're going to get one. And we did.
It's important when you're handling snook to watch out for those teeth. They're very sharp. Removing hooks with a pair of pliers makes a lot of sense. Once we'd located the fish, it was just a matter of dropping a lure over the back for an instant cut.
It's only a matter of time, trust me.
Trust the skipper. The This guy's going back to mum, there's no doubt about that. This lure is amazing. It's taken just about every... We've had two lures out all the way along here. This little fight and whiting, Hawkeye fight and whiting, has taken everyone. Little guys. That's the green lure again. It's amazing. Every run.
Well, the snook action with the inking was pretty hot. You basically see the whiting action next week.
A couple of weeks ago, we tested the 5-metre Quintrex sea breeze. This is its little brother, the Escape 4.5 metre. It's one of my favourite quinnies. It's a great little boat. We've got about 10 or 12 knots of reeds here today at North Haven. We're going to take it out on the Gulf and really put it through its paces. I'm looking forward to it.
The Escape's a very easy boat to use single-handed. It comes off the trailer with a minimum of effort. The Escape's hull's extremely efficient. It works quite nicely with the Yamaha 40. There's absolutely no need for more power. Throttle response is excellent. Like most Quintrex hulls, this one really loves a bit of a chop. She's certainly nippy over calm water, with a top speed of around 30 knots. That zip-back canopy from Harris Motor Trimmers is great. Being able to see right around the boat while you're driving is the only way to go. Seating is very comfortable. It's a terrific little boat for all sorts of applications. There's no need to winch the Escape back on at all. Just line her up, power away. Bermuda rod holders are a worthwhile accessory. Those raised battery shelves are a great idea. Cockpit shelf storage is abundant, and drink holders are a handy inclusion. Soft drinks, of course.
Well, as you can see, it got a bit nasty out there where we were testing the Escape. It's come through with flying colours. It's another great little boat from Quintrex.
Flying high above the breathtaking Great Ocean Road, Ernie checks out Port Stephens Best.
I don't know you get more fun out of this, the kids or the parents watching.
And a B&B with some unusual house guests.
In the great outdoors.
Tuesday at 8 on 7.
Before you put to sea, see Quinns. They've got the boat of your dreams for sailing, cruising, fishing, diving, socialising and family fun. Plus, Quinns have a huge range of chandlery, charts, clothing, motors and safety gear, including radios and all your marine electronics. Quinns' wide range of quality brands are all backed by professional advice, installation and service facilities. Call Quinns for the best of everything marine.
Check this out. Auto Supermarket Weekly. Colour picks of cars, 4x4s, utes, motorcycles, light commercials, boats and caravans. Black and white too. Buying or selling has never been easier. Auto Supermarket Weekly. Call 1300 36 97 98.
The boys from the bush and we're back in town. Mario Maiolo presents the Adelaide Country Music Festival, starring Lee Kernaghan, Felicity, Adam Brand, Darren Coggan and Adelaide's Ironbark. It's a star-studded spectacular for the whole family, with food and drink stalls open all day long. It's all undercover with ample parking, so see Australia's best award-winning country music superstars together. Wavell Showgrounds, November 15. Tickets from only $24.90. Hurry, book now.
Look again. It's sale time at Casabella with great savings on all leather lounges. Choose from dozens of styles and colours. So for the ultimate in leather luxury at prices you can afford. Look again and save at Casabella, 472 Paynham Road, Glynde.
Say Barnacle Bill's. Say Barnacle Bill's mouth-watering succulent seafood platter, just $21.50. Say cheesecake. That's right, cheesecake. Because right now, every Barnacle Bill's seafood platter comes with a free tangy lemon cheesecake from the Cheesecake Shop. So when you treat the family to Barnacle Bill's famous seafood platter tonight for just $21.50, treat them to a free tangy lemon cheesecake and the whole family will be smiling. Say cheesecake. Say Barnacle Bill's for the best seafood in South Australia.
While our judges search for the entries for our first camera from Ted's, there's now a second Canon camera to be won. So send your best or worst photo or video to FAB South Oz, Box 6007, Halifax Street, Adelaide 5000.
It's the Canon UC6000 camcorder from Ted's Camera Store in Rundle Street. You're guaranteed to capture the best shots with the 16x optical zoom and a whole range of other magic features. the UC6000 from Canon, and Ted's, of course.
Well, this jet ski's got more grunt than a pig. If it's fast action you want, sit back and watch this.
We've got 135 horsepower this time. It makes a big difference in handling and performance. More an advanced ski. A lot of people race with this one. Or for skiing, you could pull two people, or good fun with tubing as well.
How much quicker will it go than the 760cc model?
That one can do in excess of 63 miles an hour, or over 110 k's an hour.
Well, you don't want to get off and walk at that speed, do you?
No, it's pretty hard going when you come off at that speed.
I bet it is. What makes the Yamaha such a good wave runner?
Well, handling's very important. It's gone a long way in recent years. They've got a lot more features, including better storage, multi-function meters, and anti-theft devices built into the ignition.
Daiwa's been one of the leading names in reel manufacture for just about as long as I can remember. They make great thread lines, overheads and bait casters, and they're renowned for their smooth drags and great gearing. But they come up with a new spool design system which they call ABS, or Advanced Ballistic System, would you believe? And it really is quite clever, and it works like this. The spool is actually tapered from the front towards the back, which means that the cores of line which come off during a cast are larger, resulting in less line memory and longer distance when you cast. The spool is also a lot shallower than the normal spools, which means you don't get a lot of dead line which is buried underneath and doesn't work properly when a fish races off against the drag. It's really quite a good idea. Daiwa's ABS system is available on four series of reels, and I've got three of those here today. First one's the Regal Z, then we've got the Emblem and the Team Daiwa. And naturally these reels are available in a range of sizes to suit anything from light freshwater up to surf. It's just another great idea from Daiwa.
Marine safety officers are employed by the Marine Safety Section of Transport SA. Their job is to help promote and maintain a high standard of boating safety in our community, and they are also authorised fisheries compliance officers. Most regular boaties have at some stage probably been inspected for safety equipment, registration and licence compliance by a safety officer in their bright orange and yellow boat. Apart from giving help and advice on safety matters, they are also there to ensure that boaties operate responsibly and minimise the risk to themselves and others.
Boaties should get out early tomorrow. We'll have 10 to 15 knots south to southeasterly winds in the morning, followed by a stiff sea breeze of 17 to 22 knots. Seas will reach 1.5 metres in the afternoon. Tomorrow's tides are great for fishing of any kind. The high water will be at 6:52 a.m. and 7:08 p.m. and the lows will be at 1:34 p.m. and then again at 12:32 on Monday morning. For the boaties, Semaphore Reef has nice whiting, gar and squid.
Well, that's all I've got time for this week, but join us again next week when we head into KI. Slip into something more comfortable, plus much more. That's FAB, 5:30 next Saturday here on 7. So get your ride out of the shed and see you next week.